Hi and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how you can create a study schedule in Word with all the relevant ideas that you might want to include within that study schedule. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to hit the return key in my default document here. I go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, and then I'm going to simply choose three columns and go all the way down to the bottom. So my table's inserted. I'm just going to make a few customizations to make this process as efficient as possible. So the first thing is to select the whole table. Just click on this top left square, go to Layout and go to Height. And in here, I'm just going to make the height of my rows 0.8 and press Enter. And then over here, we can select where the text will lie within each cell. So I'm going to select align to center left click, and then I can begin to customize this table. So now I'm just going to insert some titles and then some specifications for the type of text you need to enter in. So let's just start off, and I'm going to insert some text here. I'm just going to copy and paste everything. I'm sure you don't want to watch me type everything out. And then in this column here, I'm going to merge these two cells together. So I'm going to select them, go to layout, and go to this icon here, merge cells, and then go down to the next one and then put in the title again, select here, layout, merge cells, and again here, and then we'll just insert that text. I'm going to insert some text for some suggestions. So if you can see here, we've got the week, the period, and then you can enter in here the time period you're planning to study for. And then obviously you've got your topic, there we go. Now for this one, I'm going to select three rows, again, layout, merge cells. And then in here, I'm also going to merge these cells as well, select them all, layout, merge cells. And in here, you can list your specific study goals for this week or period. Now, obviously, if you're printing this out, you don't want to put any of this text in, just delete it. And then obviously you fill it out with a pen. So the next thing we're going to do is just go down to the bottom right here, or the bottom row. We're going to go to layout, and we're going to go to this icon here that says insert rows below. And we're just going to keep clicking on that all the way down the page and onto our second page. And that will give us a full 2 pages to insert 7 days worth of study periods. So we're going to leave a row blank here. So I'm going to select it, layout, merge cells, and leave that blank. But I'm also going to take out the ends here, these two lines, so select it, go to table design, go to borders, click on the drop down, take out the left border, and then take out the right border. There we go, and you can see those border lines have been taken out. Now the cell still exists, but the border lines are no longer showing. So in here, we'll select day one. We will customize this text. So we're going to go to home, bold, we'll take that up to 16. And then because we've customized that, I'm going to copy it. Click copy on the home tab. Then I'm going to count down 4 rows, click, and then paste, Command or Control V. Do exactly the same again, leaving 4 rows clear, just so that we can insert some data. The reason I'm doing this is because it is the most efficient way of doing it without having to go back and customize everything. So I want 7 of these, there we go. And then just change the numbers, day 2, 3, etc. Perfect. And then what we're going to do is grab this line by hovering over the top of it, and then we're going to click and drag it over to the left. Then for this line, we're going to select it, layout, merge cells, click and do exactly the same, merge cells, and you can continue to do that. And then the row above your day, like we've done here, we've left a gap. So above the day, we're going to select the row above, merge it, and then once again, we're going to take out those border lines. Now, as you can see, all the border lines are checked. We'll just uncheck the left and right one, take those out, and again, merge. Now we're going to count down 3, and we're going to leave a gap here as well. So we're going to merge that one as well. Layout, merge, we've just done that. And then take out those border lines as well. Then we're just going to select this row here for additional information. We're going to merge that one as well. And then we're going to select 4 of these and then go to merge cells as well. Then we'll select these cells here, hover over that line, click, and then just move that set of lines or that line over within that set of cells. Then we're going to do the same with these groups of three rows. We're going to move them all over to the right, and those can be used as our checkboxes when the task has been completed. So the next thing to do is to select all of these six cells within this group and merge them. Perfect, and we see where day five has been split over two pages, we're going to split the whole table. So if I select this row here, go to layout, go to split table, and then I'm going to move that one down, just press the return key, see my return key is here, you see day five is at the top here. We've got too many rows split across into the third page, so I'm going to delete those, so select them, right click, delete cells, click OK. They're still there, you might have to delete one more cell here or one more row. Delete cells, OK. There we go. And at the bottom here, you can see these two lines. I'm going to nudge this whole table down a bit to just give us a little bit more space at the top for the title. And then you can see there's this line up here, borderline. Select the table, go to table design, border, and let's just take out the top border, which is that one, so that that line has disappeared. And then above here, we're just going to press the return key up just to get rid of this third page. And then let's get rid of that cell there if we can. Right click, delete row. There we go. Perfect. Okay, so now we can insert all of our information. So let's go to day one. And in here, we've got study session one, the start time and the end time. Again, you don't need to insert that if you don't want to. You can just write that in. And in here, this is what we've inserted. I'm just going to go up to this icon here. You can see that this one's missing its bullet point. So insert your cursor just before it. Go to this tab here, click on it, and select this icon here, and it will give you that bullet point. If you need to spread these out so that they link perfectly with these rows, you can simply select them all, go to the Home tab, click on this icon here, click on the drop down, and take this to 1.5, and you can see they've been spread out so they align with the checkbox at the end. The reason I didn't put these all into different cells, one on its own, is because it's quite time consuming, but you can keep them so they're split into rows without merging all of this area together. Put each of these on a separate line. So I'm going to speed up the video, go ahead and insert all the different information into each of the separate days, and then come back at the end, insert the title and the additional information. Okay, in here we're going to put in additional information, and then we're going to customize that, select it, go to the Home tab, we're going to put that to bold and also font size 16, and then again insert some text, we're going to insert bullet points. We've got some additional lines here that can be used for notes. You can keep it out as it is, or you can go ahead, select each row, go to layout and select merge, and just simply use these as note lines. I've actually got a shortcut key for this. And if you want to know how to create that shortcut key, then I will put the video in the link below. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do to make each section stand out is select each section, go to table design. I'm going to change the size of the outside border. So I'm going to click on this drop down menu. I'm going to go to 2.25 points. That's just the thickness of the line that we're going to create. Go to borders and click on the drop down. And I'm going to select outside borders. And as you can see, we've now got a thicker border around the outside of that section. And that just makes a separation between each section, just looks a little bit more professional. And then to insert the title, you can simply type it in at the top if you want to, but I like a little bit more versatility. So I'm going to insert text box, click on the drop down, draw text box, click and drag. I'm going to type in study schedule. Then I'm going to select it all, go to the Home tab. I'm going to go to this increase font size tool here. I'm just going to keep clicking till I'm happy with the size. I'm going to underline it, Then here I'm going to select center text. If I deselect it, you can see we've got this borderline, which I want to get rid of. So select it, go to shape format, go to outline and select no outline. Then you can go over to align, click on the drop down and select align to center. And then that's perfectly centered for you. What this does, it allows me to move this up and down as I see fit, gives me just that little bit more flexibility. As you see me going down, you can see there's also a white border. We can go back up to shape format, go to shape fill, click on the drop down and select no fill. That background will disappear. So once you're happy with all of that, you can go ahead and you can go to file. You can either save it to your computer or you can save it as a template. What that means is that you can come back time and time again, you can make various changes to it, but the original template will always be saved. So if you click on save as template, make sure this option is selected, the folder templates, but also make sure your file format is Microsoft Word template. Once you're happy with that, just click save, and then you can find your templates. When you open up your Word software, it's there on the home page. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe, and have a great day.